Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Monday, June 14th, 2010. Well, in the pre-market this morning, we've got futures up across the board, so we are looking for a higher open Monday morning at 9:30. Now, last week was our sixth week of a weekly downtrend for the TSX. What we're looking at right now is our first target is the previous week's high up at 11,842. We would expect that to act as resistance if this market can continue to go higher from here. Last week, we had a bullish reversal day on Tuesday. We saw a lot of the major indexes put in bullish reversal days, and we continued to see a fall through to the upside for many of them. For a lot of the major indexes, we actually had a bullish reversal week, so that marks the potential market bottom for this run to the downside. So we had the industrials, metals and mining, we had the Dow, the NASDAQ, the S&P Bank Index, the S&P or the Amex Oil Index all had bullish reversal weeks. That's just a small sample of them. And so this chart pattern often marks a market bottom. And so we're looking for fall through to the upside to confirm. If we break down below last week's lows, then those signals are no longer in place. Looking at the TSX, looking at the midterm, weekly midterm chart, you can see we have not closed below the channel line there. The oscillator at the bottom is still positive, so long-term money, even though we've had a weekly sell signal, long-term money has not left the market yet, and we're still trading in the middle of the flypaper channel. That uptrend line is still holding, and so we haven't had a major breakdown. All we've had so far is a pullback. Moving on, taking a look at some daily charts for the TSX, we came up on Friday's high, came up to the upper channel line. A daily close above 11,699 on Monday would give us a daily buy signal. For the energy stocks, we're still on a buy signal. A close below 278.30 would give us a sell signal on Monday. For financial stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 176.94 to give us a buy signal on Monday. For gold stocks, we're trading in a triangle. We've made lower highs and higher lows, and so we're looking for a breakout of this triangle. Close a daily close below 360.04 on Monday would give us a sell signal for the gold index. For materials, we're still looking for a buy signal here. We're looking for a daily close above 336.30 on Monday. Looking at the venture exchange, we're looking for a daily close above 1477.19 to give us a buy signal. For the Canadian dollar, we're now on a buy signal. We've made a higher low, and a higher high, so we are looking for higher prices here. We need a daily close below 94.60 to generate a sell signal. For the U.S. dollar, we're still on a buy signal. We came down to the lower channel line on Thursday but did not close below it. We need a daily close below 87.38 to give us a sell signal on Monday. Looking at copper, we came up to the upper channel line on Friday. We need a daily close above 294. The uptrend copper index, we started posting the charts on the weekend. We'll update them daily. We've got a beta list up right now, which we're making some adjustments to, and we'll probably have the final list by this weekend. Daily close above 22.22 would give us a buy signal on this index on Monday. Looking at gold, we need a daily close below 12.18 to give us a sell signal on Monday. For crude oil, we're looking for a daily close below 74.94. We're up again in the pre-market on Monday. Interesting that the public is giving up control. The pros aren't really taking control at the present time. Kind of odd, but it is what it is, and prices are continuing to rise. Natural gas, we're looking for a close below 457 to give us a sell signal on Monday. The line I drew across the screen is at the 450 level, which is the highs from the April highs, and it's the top of the channel, and we expect that top of the channel to act as support if natural gas wants to pull back. Looking at a couple of stocks that generated buy signals on Friday, we've got a buy signal in Potash, we've got a buy signal in Bank of Nova Scotia, we've got a new buy signal in IM Gold, and we've got a new buy signal in Husky Energy as of Friday's close. Looking at 60-minute charts for Monday's trading activity for the TSX, we're right in the hourly flypaper channel. Panic zone chart is pointing higher at the present time. First target to the upside would be that open gap up at 11,800. On the downside, if we start trading below 11,611, that would generate a new intraday sell signal on Monday. For energy stocks, we're looking at testing the recent high. An hourly close below 285.97 would generate an hourly sell signal on Monday. For financial stocks, we're looking for an hourly close below 173.21 to generate a sell signal on Monday. For gold stocks, we can remain bullish as long as we remain above 363.70. For material stocks, we can remain bullish on Monday as long as we continue to trade above 333.03. Okay, that's all for Monday morning's trading, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.